Hello sir, how are you doing?
I'm great, good. Good morning.
So, how are you feeling being here at Pragati Mega?
Excited to come here. First of all, this is my first time. And I think I should come now more often, and this induces me to write more. But this is my first experience at an actual book where I am an author. It's a very proud feeling for me also.
So, before we deep dive into your book, can you give me an idea about how your childhood was with the world of literature?
So I will give credit to my brother, who actually induced me and forced me to read a lot of novels during school. I was a great fan of Amar Chitra Katha, children comics, Superman, Batman, and I followed them quite religiously. Post that, somewhere at around I think 8th standard, I got interested to read Western comics. And that's also one of the sketches that I do later. That Clint Eastwood type of stories really would attract me, and that's how I went into reading. But then of course James Bond and thriller movies were something which was like I moved on to. In fact, I remember during my college days I would carry a novel rather than my textbook.
Oh nice, that's wonderful. So any favorite genre out of all the ones you have read?
Yes, Sydney Sheldon.
Oh, very nice. Okay.
Initially, it was James Hardlich's younger days. Then, of course, Robin Cope. But I think Sidney Sheldon is far the best, even now.
Now, coming to your book, what was the main purpose of writing this book?
Okay, so during my corporate life, I was always had this ambition that I should quit at age 45. But due to financial reasons and of course parents' illness and a lot of these types of issues, which I thought that a corporate background will really help you. So I delayed the matter a little bit and I finally got retired at 55. So the idea of early retirement was that I wanted to do, at that time I wanted to do training basically, because I am a coach. I like to teach people. In fact, my team members called me Gyan Guru, because I always give a lot of Gyan, and I myself teach a lot of self-development things. I do a lot of personality development classes, courses. So I want to do something where people should plan something for their life. Why to wait till retirement?
Understood.
So I see everybody planning for their job, career, growth, but they will never plan for the retirement.
Correct.
In fact, one question which I don't think anybody asks in their career is, what is the retirement age of this company?
Correct.
When you ask, when the interviewer asks, do you have any questions, you never ask this question. So you really don't know, should I retire at 58, 60, or is it 65? So my this will be, I'm a little bit pushing people that after you plan for your retirement post 60, but you plan for a little bit something else also. Because if you today Google retirement or anything on retirement, you'll only get financials. You get financial planning, you get a lot of other things, but you will never get something on social. You'll not get social, you'll not get anything on physical, you'll not get anything on family, you don't not get anything even on your physical attributes. So this book is just a very small book, just induces you or it encourages you to plan, one, of course, for your proper retirement, and then it maybe it also attracts, or it will attract you to retire a year or so before. And it's a very niche market. I'm not telling everybody to retire. I'm saying those guys who have reached the top of their career. They are financially well sound, the children are all studying abroad, now they are sitting all alone at home, just for time pass they are working. So if you leave a year or so, there are so many things which are. One, you give a chance for your lower team to come up, you open up the horizons for a lot of people. Second is you give some sort of I would say a way of life to a lot of people. The family will always thank you, because now you are there full time. Your parents, who always are cribbing that you are never there, will just love you and bless you like mad. One of the reason I was writing this book is because I was thinking I should retire 2-3 years before my mother died. Because whatever time I could spend, I didn't think I could spend much time. But yes, today my wife is a entrepreneur working from home. So she is quite happy that I am at home working with her. So I'm not saying that you retire and do nothing. You can do a lot of things. But the idea is that you do things which you like. And when you like, you will really do a lot of things which will make you happy and it will add value to the society.
एक व्यक्ति का पर्स खोया हुआ है, हरमनजोत सिंह पंजाब से आए हुए हैं, उनका ब्राउन पर्स किसी भी व्यक्ति को यदि वह ब्राउन कलर का पर्स मिलता है वह हॉल नंबर 5 के रिसेप्शन काउंटर पर जमा कर दें। कृपया ध्यान दें, ब्राउन पर्स हरमनजोत सिंह नाम से उनके डॉक्यूमेंट्स हैं और नंबर 5 के रिसेप्शन काउंटर पर भी क्या जमा करा दें।
It depends on not sure. Maybe one of them who knows Gujarati might have heard. Mostly either Subham or Jalani. One of them might have heard.
Ready?
Yeah.
So, sir, I have one question as someone who's just started working. If I have to retire by maybe let's say 55,
yeah.
By what age do you think I should start planning?
You should start planning at 45.
45, okay.
It depends on what is the purpose you want.
Got it.
If you want to have a big, like a luxurious lifetime, you will have to start a little bit early.
Okay.
It depends, that's what. The first planning is what is it you want at age 55. You want a 4 BHK, you want a big car, you want to go on a cruise, so you know the amount. Right?
Mm.
It's very clear. You have to work towards that and it's really very simple. I am not talking in my book about financial planning. I am tapping more on the other aspects, which is the physical
Correct.
One.
Mm.
Lot of my friends at age 60 say I want to go on a world tour and all that. By the time they have diabetes and BP and all, they will not go to travel. And then they will really creep that now I can't go abroad because of health problems. So you do all that at age 45 to 55, right? And then you do all the other social work that you need. So, the idea is that COVID has also taught us, right, that nothing is, life is uncertain, anything can happen. So the idea is that you should plan, and I would only recommend that you plan that something may happen. God forbid, or God, I pray to God nothing should happen, but then why take a chance? Like COVID, nobody knew what happened. So work from home is never an option, but today it's like a norm. So if you have planned before, in fact this thing what we were doing, I had created an office in my own residence and I had one of the, I think at that time one of, I was the only one who had an office in my residence working whole time fully and where everybody was working in their bedrooms and with dining tables. I had a proper table, Wi-Fi with a executive chair with full lightings and all. It just needs planning. My issue is people don't plan for the unforeseen and they don't plan for retirement. I have a lot of my colleagues who say, what will I do after retirement? It will be so boring. I am refusing to accept that. I am saying that there is so many things to do. Why are you working for only one company or one person? So there is really so many things. Like I discovered that I can do sketches. I always used to do Western comics and all. One fine day I had a lot of time and said, let me try portraits, and I got a good portrait. The first portrait I did was of Mona Lisa, which is the only famous portrait in this world, and I got a good likeness of it. So I said, let me continue. I actually took classes and then finally I reached where I am today, and I can go a lot more. But there are a lot of things which I do. I do singing, I do karaoke singing, which you will never do when you are actually working, because you are 100% so involved in your work. So you should be passionate. Both when you are working, you should be passionate. You save in that manner, and you save in such a prudent manner that you keep something for the retirement, but not that you don't eat today to save. You should enjoy today also. So these are some of the tips which doesn't get featured in a lot of books which I saw, which is mentioned on retirement. Because I researched a lot of books. It was more or less only on financial planning and all those things. But they have not planned how to get ready. Because when you retire, your family who has never seen you for 16 hours suddenly sees you 24 hours. That is the first shock that you will get and they will get. So how do you prepare yourself for them to be there? Like you will start chai lao, coffee lao, paper lao, khana lagao. Your family will not tolerate that. Your pets may not tolerate that. Who is this guy oldest? Your neighbors may not. So there is all this we need to get acclimatized. You have to understand, boss. It will take me. So how do you do that? You start slowly. You start with hybrid working. You take lesser assignments. You tell your management that I am not going to work. Give me lesser offer. You know, my salary will go down. All that you can start planning. You can't do overnight. Nothing happens overnight. It will take some 2-3 years maybe. And today, let me tell you that not I will say credit to my book, but I am very happy to note that a lot of seniors in my group, I used to work for the Aditya Birla Group, one of the largest conglomerates in India. I have seen a lot of people leaving at age 50, 55. They are becoming consultant in their chosen field. Some becomes accountant, some legal, some statutory, something on HR. But they are doing only what they want to do, and it's the same for me and my wife. We only take what we like to do and at what time we will do. We are not running after business. We have a successful business which is going on since last 8 years. My wife used to run it. We are HR consultants. We do training. We do a lot of HR work. But only what we like to do and what we can do. It's not that anything and everything which is there. Like we don't do hardcore recruitment. We don't do that. We do search. That's it.
Now, coming to, you know, how was your journey publishing the book? Were there any times that it took you some time to put down your thought process? Did you ever have like a mind block?
So, publishing the book, initially I was never planning to publish a book. My thoughts was to have a course, either an online course or something which I can prepare where there will be these types of modules. How to plan, what to plan, financial, physical, all that. Then I saw, when I started speaking to people, I saw that I was not getting very much encouragement. People were very happy. Oh, good, I will also attend. But then nobody has the time. Any courses nowadays. So I said, then I will have to write. So I am, I would say I am a little bit okay in writing. My English spoken is not that very fluent, but I can write rather good English. So I said, let me put it down. So I started writing. So there are a lot of things in Google if you see how to write and all. So I took some tips that put it in chapters and all. But I got 2-3 chapters very strongly. I needed to have these three, four things like how to plan, what are the financial implications, and how do you go about it. One chapter which is very important here, which I always say, is that we have three F's, right? Flight, and we have this one which I have added is faith. And I am saying that you should have faith in yourself. Why are you not having faith in yourself, your capabilities, your skill set, your education, and finally on God, that it will help you if you are deciding to go out, whatever you are wanting to become. So I started writing, and I think out of the blue I got to hear about the right order because of some direct mailers or something, and I contacted you guys, and it was quite a smooth experience. Initially it was here and there some things, but I think it was quite happy, and I'm quite happy with the way it went. And I had planned it to launch it during my birthday, which was May 12th, last year, and I was happy that it happened quite well. Shubham is there from the one I think is
That's
Hope
nice.
To continue.
That's wonderful. So, any last final message to the viewers of this video?
I would only say that please plan your life carefully and don't be afraid of retirement. Don't be afraid of age 60. In fact, you should welcome it. Just like how when you are writing your board or your school exams, you say vacation, I'll do so many things. It's like that after retirement, I'll do. I'm saying, why do you even wait until 60? Give that 1 or 2 years to your family, they will really cherish this experience. Post 60, you do a lot of other things, but at this age, this 2-3 years, what you can plan to retire early, you can give to your family only. After 60 you take that. You can say this is now my life, I have retired. But give this because after 60 you will not have the energy maybe. I'm not saying something will happen to you, but you may not have the energy and health-wise your family may also not be capable to roam around or you know enjoy with you. So why wait? So I'm just saying plan.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for your time. You can grab your copies on Amazon and you can also visit our stall at C13 Pragati Magadan for getting your copies. Thank you, sir. Have a nice day.